So that's the virtual reality concert, di ba? Yan ang patikim ng 10th anniversary celebration ni Alden Richards. And para sa mga kapuso abroad natin ngayon na wala sa Pilipinas, you can use your existing VR device since the VR device for Alden's reality is being offered to Philippine buyers only. And you can also encourage your relatives in the Philippines na bumili ng VR device para sa inyo. Alright, so proceed na tayo sa ating Q&A portion. Unahin natin na magtatanong si Mr. Bradford Adkins, all the way from San Francisco.
Oh, hi, Alden. How are you? Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Hi. Congratulations, Alden. The first time I met you and I saw you in person was in Los Angeles.
So ngayon, sir, I really can't ask for more. Parang sa 10 years ko po in showbiz, ang dami na po nangyari. And I'm very blessed po with, you know, good people behind my back who are continuously helping me.
Good people behind my back who are continuously helping me.
And, you know, do the things that I love to do na with 100% support. So ngayon, sir, talagang I'm just waiting for what's in store in the future. But to consider ko lang po talaga is all the projects we'll be doing in the future is something different. Ngayon po kasi parang ang invention type of projects. I want something different. I want something that's new to me as well. So matetest ko po yung sarili ko kasi parang ang dami na pong projects before na medyo nagiging stereotype on my part and wala na po akong nakikitang challenge doon. So I think parang isa sa mga 10th year reinventions ko sa sarili ko is to try different projects and do different things like this virtual reality concert. Something new for our kapusos all over the world.
Ang question ni Sir JB Alden, as the lead artist, what are the protocols in place behind the production of AR to ensure a COVID-safe work environment?
Well, a few days prior to the shoot, we did swab testing for all the people involved for the concert. Since malaking production siya as opposed to having... Actually, parang pareho nga lang siya when you're doing a live concert. But syempre, parang since nga given the circumstance of COVID, yun yung mga kailangan gawin na protocols to do work here in the Philippines. Actually, hindi lang naman siguro dito po, but all over the world. So, swab testing and then upon very minimal people yung involved, dapat parang as much as possible, yung isang tao na with a specific task or job sa production, minsan double task sila eh. Parang ganun to really ensure yung minimal workforce required inside the actual shoot. And then, pagdating po dun sa set, syempre, andun pa rin yung every hour monitoring ng temperature, tapos disinfection, social distancing is strictly implemented. And, pero that didn't stop us naman po to have fun in the shoot and para matapos namin yung mga kailangan po namin tapusin on that day.
Maraming salamat, Sir Jamie. Ayan, kahit napuputol siya, ito naman, naitawid naman natin, di ba? Salamat, Sir JB, for your questions. Ayan, ituloy naman natin kay Ms. Florenda Corpus or kay Ms. Dang.
Hi, Alden.
Hi, Ms. Dang, how are you? Kumusta po?
Okay naman. Miss ka na ng mga fans mo dito sa Japan.
Ako, one of my favorite countries, ma'am. Kung mas miss ko po kayo dyan.
congratulations sa 10th anniversary mo. Tsaka sa upcoming concert mo. Alden's Reality, napakagandang titulo.
Yes, ma'am.
Pero bago ito, Alden, pwede mo bang ibahagi sa amin kung sino talaga si Alden Richards and ano ba yung realidad niya ngayon?
Well, sa ngayon po, actually, yung nakikuha naman po yung nakikita nyo on TV and kung paano ako sa ibang tao is really how I am in real life. So there's no difference. Walang Walang Alden on screen, off screen. It's the same person. And currently, reality now, syempre, medyo mahirap with what's happening. Ang daming adjustments. That's why we're calling it the new normal as of the moment. But that's the way to survive. We have to adapt to survive. And, you know, parang since we really value the people and we value our kapuso here in the Philippines and abroad, parang to really celebrate po my 10th anniversary in show business, we have created something that is safe and yet will give them 100% experience of a concert. Even walang hindi po kailangan pumunta physically sa actual venue. And parang it's our treat to them, parang it's my treat to them since it's my 10th anniversary. And yun, excited po ako na we were able to showcase something new and you know, a different experience for the concert goers. Of course, for our kapusos all over the world.
Sa panayam namin sa'yo before sa press con ng The Gift,
yes po.
Na sinulat namin dito, ikaw yung cover. May ibahagi mo sa amin na ano, na ang greatest gift na natanggap mo to date is the gift of being an actor.
Yes.
Alden, 10 taon sa industriya, achievement yun. Pwede mo bang i-share sa amin kung ano yung pinaka grateful ka and ano yung nilulook forward mo sa susunod na 10 taon mo sa industry?
Wow. Good question. 10 years po, as hindi po naging madali sa akin yung journey na yun. But kung meron lang po talaga akong ipagpapasalamat, actually, it's really yung na-bless po ako ng mga mabubuting tao na tumulong sa akin and sumama sa akin through ups and downs ng career ko. And parang that's what I'm really grateful for kasi I would never reach 10 years without these people and they know who they are. So, kasi syempre, ang success is best experience when you share it to other people who are with you. So, dun po ako pinaka-best is to really have people yung that encourage me, that gives me unconditional love and support. That's the thing that I'm really grateful for and that's what keeps me going in this industry. Kasi 10 years po is a long time. Nagulat na lang din po ako na 10 years na rin ako sa showbiz. But siguro hindi mo talaga mapupunta yung panahon na lumilipas kapag you really enjoy staying in a particular job that you really love sincerely. And for me, yun po yung pagiging actor. That's why siguro yung in the next 10 years that's gonna come, sana more challenges. Kasi wala naman pong victory kapag madali lahat ng ginagawa. Eh, mas masarap yung victory pag challenging yung pinagdadaanan natin. And at the same time, mas marami pang ma-inspire na tao with the things that I do po.
Thank you, Alden. Hintayin ka namin ulit dito sa Japan.
Thank you, ma'am. See you soon po. Ingat po kayo.
Ingat. Salamat.
Ayan, maraming salamat, Miss Dang. Ayan, ang susunod naman na magtatanong, si Sir Gary De Guzman. Also, he's also in San Francisco.
Hi, Francesca. Hi, Alden.
Hello, Sir Gary.
From San Francisco, California, Film Star Newspaper.
No
po. And thank you so much for inviting us. First of all, I'd like to congratulate you to a happy 10th anniversary for GMA.
Thank you.
I have two questions for you. Una, anong sa susunod mong na concert or project, sino gusto mong makatambal or makatrabaho? And then my second question is, ano yung gusto mong gawin sa kakaibang para sa susunod mong project?
Okay po. So with the first question, sir, parang sa tagal ko naman po sa showbiz industry, I've been paired with a lot of leading ladies already. And parang that's isa rin po yun sa mga pinagpapasalamat ko kasi every time I discover something new sa mga bagong katrabaho. Ako naman po, no one in particular, but kung sino man po yung mabigyan ako ng chance to work with and magkaroon ng magandang project na magawa, kahit sino naman po ako, I'm really open to anyone. I'm not choosy whenever pagdating naman po sa partners kasi depende po sa project yan. And doon naman po sa second question, parang I wanted to do more roles na pang actor po talaga. That's how I would like to put it. Parang it's not the typical Alden Richards on TV, not the typical Alden Richards on movies. Something na siguro po para sa akin is yung kung saan mas how should I say? Parang kasi I've done this movie a few years ago. It's called Put the Road and it's a bit dark. And I was quite surprised po na I was able to do it effortlessly. So parang yun po yung mga gusto kong magawang projects in the near future. More edgy roles, yun. Edgy roles po. Mas matetest po yung capacity ko as an actor than yung parang laging leading man, laging goody-goody, laging ganun. So something different naman po. I mean, it's for me as an actor. Na parang for growth din po, para hindi naman tayo nakakasawang panoorin since for the past 10 years, puro ganun po yung roles ko na nagagawa ko.
Thank you.
Yan, sir. Thank you po.
Salamat, Sir Gary. Ayan. Si Sir Manny naman, yan, sinend niya yung kanyang questions dito sa ating chat box also. Ayan. So, Alden, ano daw ang what would be the most visually noticeable difference between pre-COVID productions of shows such as your concert and kung paano siya ginagawa ngayon? In terms of crew size and scheduling, meron bang ano difference? Ganyan.
So, Sir Manny, sobrang laking difference po kasi pre-COVID, pag sinabi po kasing, like especially let's put it in concert production, marami po talagang required na tao dyan. I mean, the manpower is really big pagdating po sa concert productions. Kasi of course, you set up the venue, tapos you take care of the technicals, and then at the same time, security as well. Marami rin pong required na tao for that. As opposed to now, the current situation, which is COVID, sobrang bawas po ng almost 50 to 60% yung workforce. And nasanay po kasi talaga ako na whenever I go on set, regardless kung concert production man or taping on TV, marami talagang taong involved. So na ngayon sobrang bawas including sa tapings kasi of course we, yun nga po yung sinasabi ko kanina na parang yung trabaho ng isa na dagdagan, parang nag-times to yung kailangan niyang gawin on set, you know, just to really cut the people on set kasi of course, we're really concerned about the safety. Hindi lang po ng mga artista, but of course, everybody. Hindi naman, kumbaga, ito po kasi nangyayari sa atin ngayon, hindi lang naman to para sa mga public figures, mga artista, whoever. It's for everyone's safety, on and off cam. And parang, I don't know po with regards to budget, kung mas tipid ba. Pero I think, yes, parang if we look at it, kasi since less people is required, so less people is compensated. So parang, yes, I think mas nakakatipid po yung production house when it comes to what's happening now. Kasi mas konti po yung taong nire-require to work on certain projects.
Alright, salamat sa tanong mo, Sir Manny. Ha? Ayun, tinatanong ni Sir Manny, sino daw yung lady behind you in the charcoal picture frame daw, Alden?
That's my mom. It was given to me po by a fan. They're knowing siya way back 2016.
Wow, naman. Talagang very, ano yung, ano, tribute talaga. And especially close to your heart kasi it's your mom and it's from a fan. Yeah. Sobrang nakakatuwa naman. Alden, ituloy ko lang ha. Someone sent us a question also from Manila Up Magazine. It's from Nahia Lajoie. So, now that we're in the topic, no, what inspired you daw to take part of a virtual concert during this time in particular? And why is it important to you? And bakit mo, why do you hope to accomplish or think it will inspire viewers during this time?
Nung una talaga, we're very apprehensive with the idea. Parang we're not sure, is this gonna work? Because we studied the current situation and of course, ang dami na rin concerts online na nangyayari. And parang how are we gonna make this different from all those online concerts? And ayun, si Direk Pao, along with his team, parang thought of this virtual reality thing. Because virtual reality has always been there. It's not new naman sa atin. Parang ang dami na ring attractions and certain parang mga era, let's say like games and other stuff na that involves virtual reality. So, but dito sa Pinas, parang there has never been a virtual reality concert. So, parang kasi plinano na namin tong concert pre-pandemic pa lang. So, dapat nga last July ito and then it was supposed to happen in Araneta Coliseum. And then parang since COVID came in, parang walan kami ng pag-asa na parang, of course, this is not gonna push through because of the given protocols. And then parang we wanted to do it na lang online, kaya lang sa parang sabi ko, paano natin siya magagawang different compared dun sa mga ibang nangyayari ng online concerts. And then the VR idea came up. We were not sure. We pitched it to GMA. And then parang GMA took the risk. Parang let's try. Let's try doing this. And parang so far, hindi naman kami yung feedback na nakukuha namin and the yung ticket sales na nakukuha ng concert ngayon is really above expectations. We didn't expect that people would be very excited for this concert. Kasi sabi ko, parang sayang naman if we're not gonna do anything. It's the 10th year, kumbaga, that marks a milestone for an actor or an actress na parang to reach that long in the industry. So, parang na-timing din talaga lahat. Everything was in perfect timing. Parang 10th year, tapos we're introducing a new technology in terms of concerts. And parang this time na syempre yung mga tao ngayon gigil nang lumabas, gigil nang bumalik sa talagang kung ano yung normal natin before. But when we do something good, when we parang want to create something nice to the audience, we also want to be concerned of their safety as well, especially given the current situation na. And at the same time, parang it's gonna be new ako. Parang it's new for me to be able to watch a virtual reality concert in the comforts of my home. So we also want that for them na parang hindi naman natin hayaan malumagpas tong 10th year, 10 years ni Alden Richards na wala tayong may offer for our supporters who has been there for the past 10 years. So rest assured na we have done something, actually, we have done something magical out of this concept. And I just want to share it to my supporters as well. And to, you know, this is really for them, you know, to look back on the 10 years na ano na bang, nasa na ba tayo, ano yung mga pinagdaanan natin. Kasi ako, kahit ako personally, when I watch it, nung binasa ko yung the whole treatment about the concert, nagulat din ako na yun na pala yung mga nangyari. So, ito parang summary lang, parang balik tanaw. You know, of course, syempre dun talaga sa mga solid supporters natin dyan. And, ayun, sana halos lahat, of course, may experience to. And, of course, tickets are still available. Pero yung VIP tickets natin, almost sold out na. Pero sa lahat po ng mga nakabili na, stay tuned and we can't wait for you guys to see it.
Ayun naman. Kaya, di ba, kanina sabi mo, you were guys quite feeling hopeless but given the situation. Pero tignan mo naman kung ano yung mangyayari ngayon nakapalit. I mean, the setback became an advantage in a way kasi naging pioneering itong virtual reality concert mo, di ba? And it's gonna be safe and everyone's gonna enjoy it, di ba? All your supporters in the past 10 years and more years to come. Di ba? And it's also safe for everyone, including you, di ba? Kasi yung everyone in your team are very secured and very tight ang security para maprotektahan ng isa't isa. Kasi, syempre, yung swab pa lang, medyo may halaga na. So, also, in a way, it's not necessarily cheap ang production natin, hindi ba? Ayan. So, tuloy na natin, Alden, no? Kasama natin ngayon si Miss Donna Reyes, all the way from Chicago.
Hello, everyone. Hello, Alden. And hello to my friends dyan sa GMA. I'm very happy for you. Congratulations on your 10 years.
Thank you,
ma'am. And you not know, actually, you and I started about the same time. Yes, I remember, and I'm happy that you mentioned The Road. I cannot believe that that was one of your first movies because you really are a really good actor. So I'm very happy to be here. Thank you, Cheska, for inviting me. So my questions are, first, looking back at those 10 years, do you remember that moment when you felt you made it? Or na papasokan na dun, sa, o natutupad mo na unti-unti yung, you know, goals mo or dreams mo in, you know, in the industry?
Well, ma'am, ako naman po parang I don't really want to feel that feeling na I've made it. Siguro lang po naramdaman ko na natupad ko na po yung mga pangarap ko. That's parang a better way to put it. Nung nabilan ko po ng bahay yung family ko here in Laguna, parang sabi ko, ay, ito na yan. Parang all of my dreams are starting to be fulfilled. But siguro po, doon naman po sa parang I've made it part, in everything that I do, hindi ko po parang sinasabi na, ah, ito na ako. Kasi nawawala, parang for me, it's the end of me to be, yung growth po, dun nagsistop yung growth when you feel like you've made it in a certain thing that you're doing. So I'm always, I'm constantly hungry for more knowledge and experience. And every success naman po that I have achieved is, hindi ko po sinasarili yun. It's always a collective effort. Of course, dun sa mga tipo, sa mga taong tumulong po sa akin, you know, to achieve that success. So, siguro yun din po yung way ko para mas mag-improve sa sarili and, you know, to be different, improved version po of myself in every project that I do.
You have not really changed. You're still very humble. And I also congratulate, you know, our friend there in GMA who really are, you know, instrumental also in building you up as the artist as you are now. Of course, there's raw talent, but there's also that support that you acknowledge, and that's very, you know, humble of you also. My second question is, given your influence as Asia's multimedia star now, you know, 10 years after your Asia's multimedia star, how do you use this influence to help those in need, especially during this pandemic?
Yes po. Since I started naman po in show business, I'm not really publicizing the things that I do to help other people po. Kasi I have no offense po. Kumbaga ako lang po to. No offense po dun sa mahilig mga mag-post on social media that they're helping out the needy or kababayans that are in need and yung mga outreach na ginagawa nila. Siguro that's their style. But for me po, I don't really have to really show it to the public. Kasi si Lord naman po yung nakakakita talaga kung ano yung ginagawa mo in your life on and off cam. And siguro that's not my style po as a sharer. That's how I as a sharer, I don't publicize any help that I give out to people. Kasi parang pagdating naman po sa ganun, ang ganung aspeto, you don't need other people's approval. Eh. It's only between you and the Lord. Kayo naman dalawa yung nakakaintindihan dun. So I just want to keep everything in private. But syempre, given other things naman po, like the pandemic, nakuha naman po tayo ng mga different organizations to promote, you know, to be of public service to our kababayans. Like, ito nga po sa DOH, yung parang yung COVID campaign natin. And at the same time, syempre, yung social relevance po ng pagiging public figure, we utilize that to, you know, bring more knowledge po sa mga kababayan natin, and na parang para hindi naman po nila din sabihin na artista. At si Alden Richards, artista lang yan, hindi naman yan socially relevant, wala naman yan pakialam sa nangyayari around us, which is syempre not true naman po. So there are certain areas or certain parang situations that calls for, you know, to make it known to the public. Yun na po yung parang social obligation po naming mga public figures.
Thank you very much again, Alden, and good luck on your concert. Not that you need it. I'm pretty sure many people are going to watch it. And I also congratulate, you know, GMA for being as innovative as ever. And lastly lang, I want to invite you. Hopefully you can make it to Chicago because you have a lot of people who love you here. You have a lot of fans. I know that for sure because they request you all the time when there are big events here. And I'm pretty sure GMA Pinoy TV can attest to that. Again, congratulations on your 10th year. And thank you for having me, Cheska.
Yes po. Thank you, Ms. Donna.
Salamat po, Ms. Donna. Ayan. So, next naman po is Sir Vin Samson from Asian Journal.
Hello, Alden. Kumusta?
Hey, sir. Kumusta po, Sir Vince? Okay naman.
Na-notice ko three things na may common tayo eh. Una-una, isang dekada na ako nakabalik sa Pilipinas from Los Angeles. So, congratulations to us na nasubaybayan ko yung time na nagsimula ka pa lang sa Itbulaga, sa Dabarcan. So, nakita ko how we've grown. Kaya ngayon, nanonood pa nga ako. May series ka na luma ngayon sa GMA. Yung sa,
yes, sir. You want
okay. Number two, ang hometown ko, taga Laguna rin. Taga Ma-JJ kami. So,
Hi.
Oh, so magandang lugar 'yon, puntahan mo rin 'yon. So tapos number three, pareho nating namimiss ang Japan. So my question is yung sa virtual reality, no. So how does it feel na to work with Paolo Valenciano as a director? Kwento sa atin.
Yes, sir, nung una na pressure talaga ako kasi parang I've seen a lot of projects ni Direk Pao with the best performers here in the Philippines. And parang, you know, parang for him to direct my concert is really an honor, and I'm so grateful na pumayag siya, na hindi naman din po talaga ako full out performer, you know, can sing, can dance lang naman, pero hindi talaga ganun kagaling.
Uh-huh.
So, kasi nung una po talaga, we were supposed to have this in a big venue. And then eventually, because of what happened, kailangan namin mag-adjust. Of course, yung new normal and safety ng mga tao po yung concern. And ang maganda rin po kasi dito, first time ko and first time din ni Direk Pao to do a VR concert, a virtual reality concert. So parang pareho kaming first time dito po sa gagawin namin. So we share the same sentiments and yung mga uncertainties na iniisip namin are there and yung apprehensions are there. But what I can really say is talagang binigay po namin lahat dito for this show and for this new concept offered by GMA. And sana po talaga magustuhan ng mga tao, and I'm sure po magugustuhan nila ta.
Okay, thank you very much. Actually, maraming mga kababayan natin sa Los Angeles, kasi sa Asian Journal ako, yung newspaper based sa Glendale, California. Are there any plans for you guys to have this concert also sa States or worldwide? So like
parang sa ngayon po, sir, kung sakali man pong natuloy sana yung Araneta, that was the plan. Kung after the 10th year anniversary, GMA is really planning to bring it in different parts of the world po. So sayang lang po hindi talaga natuloy, but siguro after this pandemic, pag andyan yung vaccine and we can, you know, do it again very soon para maiikot din po natin siya. Kasi nakakamiss din talaga mag-travel, sir.
Okay. So, yun. People in Los Angeles will be looking forward for you guys. And naman kami, partners kami sa GMA Pinoy TV sa Amerika. So, congratulations again, Alden.
Thank you, Sir Vince. Salamat po.
Okay.
Salamat, Sir Vince. Ayan, Sir Vince, idagdag ko lang, no? Lahat kayong mga nasa ibang bansa ngayon, you also get to watch Alden's reality concert.
Wow.
So Abangan natin yan sa December 8. Magkakaiba man ang mga time zone natin, mapapanood nyo pa rin.
Thank
yan.
You!
Yes, and yung mga kamag-anak ninyong nandito sa Pinas, you can also encourage them to get their VR device para mas ma-enjoy nila ng ano, bonggang-bongga ang handog ni Alden para sa ating lahat, hindi ba? Alright, so ang susunod naman na magtatanong, all the way from Dubai. Ayan, napakaaga natin siyang ginising ngayon dahil alas 6 pa lang, dyan yata sa Dubai ngayon. Sir Junie! Sorsano from Trending Pinoy is here with us. Sir Junie, naka-mute ka ata.
Unmute. All right. I think I'm good.
Ayan. Hello, perfect.
Hey, good morning. Yeah, it's 7 a.m. Kumusta, Alden?
Good morning. Okay naman, sir. Okay naman po.
I think yung last time na nakita kita dito was with Catherine pa. Yung when you promoted that movie.
Yes po.
Ayan.
Good po namin.
Okay. So my first question is, since ito nga maraming mga kapuso abroad na nami-miss ka na talaga, lalo na yung dadalaw talaga kayo sa amin, especially pag may mga malalaking events dito sa abroad. Pero with your ano virtual reality concert na to, paano mo makakonect sa mga fans mo sa ibang bansa yung 10 years ng pagiging Alden Richards mo? Meron ba tayong mga pa-throwback dito or papakita mo yung journey mo as Alden Richards?
Yes, sir, marami po. Kasi basically, the whole concert was conceptualized based on my book po that was released a few years ago. So, parang ito ginawa natin since sa book, ginawa lang natin siyang very visual for our, you know, kapuso sa abroad. So, marami silang makikita na throwbacks doon. And of course, yung ano talaga yung naging journey nung 10 years ni Alden Richards sa industry. So, marami tayong mare-reminisce doon, sir, pag napanood natin.
Okay. Yun, yung second question ko, medyo personal to ng konti. Kasi nga, I'm following you, of course, sa lahat ng mga social media post mo. And my question is, aside from, syempre, you're busy now with your Itbulaga at yung sunod-sunod na endorsements, and so you are also on online game streaming. So my question is, yes, maraming mga gamer dito sa ibang bansa. Opo. Paano mo nagagamit yung platform na ito para makakonnect ka pa rin sa mga fans mo sa Pinas or sa mga fans mo dito sa abroad?
Yun nga po, sir. Parang, syempre, I'm also in touch with other supporters din po all over the world and dito sa atin. And they're really grateful po dun sa online game streaming kasi parang yun po yung nag-compensate sa mga mall shows and out-of-the-country shows na kumbaga kahit hindi nila kami nakikita physically, andyan naman yung online. Actually, ang dami naman po talagang online platforms ngayon where you can do shows and, you know, be in touch with your supporters all over the world. So, parang yun na rin po yung away na parang a way of giving them the privilege na makita po ako personally, live, kahit hindi man in person, and at the same time, be in touch with them at the same time while doing the thing I love most, which is gaming po.
Ayun. Okay, so thank you so much and hope to see you soon. Sana maging okay na lahat and you can visit Dubai again.
Yes po.
Maraming salamat.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Ayan, maraming salamat muli. Ayan na ang mga ating mga kapuso abroad na sinamahan tayo for today's media conference. Ayan. So, meron pa bang mga pahabol na tanong kung sakali? Alright. So, mga kapuso, abangan po natin ang Alden's Reality Concert. Ayan. Ito ang pinakaunang virtual reality concert dito sa Pilipinas. At habang iniintay nyo na mapanood ang Alden's Reality dyan, para sa mga kapuso natin abroad, syempre pwede pa rin nating abangan si Alden sa mga programa niya at na mapapanood abroad via GMA Pinoy TV. Ayan, very, very supportive ang mga kapuso abroad natin na kasama ngayon for GMA Pinoy TV. Kaya maraming salamat po.